So of course in September, we finally launched our first ocean cleanup system from San Francisco. We successfully deployed the system, yeah, and then we had to wait and see, you know, what happens and how does the plastic interact with the system. Very quickly, what we saw was that the plastic started to be caught, but then not soon after, we also saw the plastic leaving the system again. So basically the catching and concentrating parts, you know, we were able to confirm, but then the retention part of actually holding the catch, that's where we saw an issue. And then suddenly, I think it was 2 days before the end of the year, you know, a second issue was discovered when an 18 meter long end section of the cleanup system actually disconnected from the rest of the system. Basically a fracture had occurred. Full priority for the whole team became to analyze the results and to understand what is truly the root cause of these issues that we saw. Then looking at the structural failure, pretty quickly after receiving the photos of the fracture, it became clear where the origin of this fracture was. And it was right at the edge where you had an interface between two dovetails. And there are the interface between the screen and the floater. What happened was that these sections, they have been welded in 1 meter section, so they weren't extruded all the way along the pipe, which caused there to be these tiny notches in between every dovetail section. What happened there was that it creates this imperfection where you get this very high concentration of stresses. This tiny stress concentration causes this tiny crack to start, and then this tiny crack becomes a slightly bigger crack and an even bigger crack, and you actually on the pictures you just see this propagation of the crack all the way through the entire 1.2 meter pipe. So while the structural failure, you know, got most of the attention from the outside world, this was actually the easy issue. It's very straightforward, you know, fatigue issues. They were there with the first railways, they were there with the first airplanes. Now they're here with the first cleanup system. So yeah, it's not a completely new science. Of course, applying it to this material and this environment is new, but it's relatively well understood. The behavior of the system, on the other hand, is extremely complicated. And you know, simply understanding why, you know, the system wasn't able to retain the plastic, you know, that has been a much more complicated question. And that is because it's such a chaotic environment. You know, you have waves, winds, currents, you have short waves, long waves, different drift forces. You have the plastic behaving in a certain way, you have the system behaving in a certain way. You have large scale effects of how the ocean behaves. You have very local effects of how the system actually influences the local patterns of currents and winds and waves. So it's just a big pool of chaos, and from all that noise, you have to distill some kind of signal, yeah, that points you in the right direction.
We are doing a drifter test at the moment, and I am the eye in the sky looking out for the drifters.
We started with some like 27 different hypotheses that we thought could be responsible or have contributed to the cause of the system not retaining the plastic.
So you start off really, really broad, brainstorming, making hypotheses. Maybe this is the reason, maybe this went wrong, maybe we overlooked this. And then you start building a case, you start collecting evidence for what you think is the hypothesis.
We had the data from the human observations, the people that were actually out there observing the system. We have the data from the Autonaut, the robotic vessel that was tracking the system and was measuring the environmental conditions. We have the data from the system itself and the strain gauges on the systems and the cameras on the systems. We did GPS tracker tests. We did dye tests, you know, to look at the behavior of the system relative to the water and to the plastic. The trick is to really find those high leverage pieces of data that increase your understanding by a lot.
One thing that was observed by each crew was that we saw plastic accumulating on the outside of Wilson, which led us and which strengthens our hypothesis to the fact that Wilson is not fast enough and that plastic in certain conditions is overtaking the system.
So what we see is that on one hand, Wilson is going slower than thought because the waves are partly shielding the system for the wind and the wave drift force is lower than thought. While on the other hand, the plastic is actually moving faster than thought because of the Stokes drift effect being stronger as well as a wind shear effect of the upper water layer, causing the current for the plastic to be faster than the current that the system feels. And then the question becomes, well, how to speed it up? When so many things did go well, and that were definitely not guaranteed that they would go well. So reflecting on that, combined with now having an understanding of the things that didn't go well, and seeing a probable path towards solving those, means that we're back on track. And yeah, I can't wait to have the system back out again.